What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Around the Table Sports. Now, before we hop into the video today, if y'all could go ahead and smash that like button, drop a comment down below to let me know what you thought about the big recruiting news last night. And yeah, just go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you're already here. Thank y'all so much for all the support, and let's keep it going because this is really what I would like to do. So with all that being said, let's talk about Kamar Wheaton, the number two running back in the class of 2021. Number one running back in the class of 2021 being Travion Henderson, I believe from Hopewell, Virginia. Henderson is committed to the Ohio State Buckeyes, and Kamar Wheaton last night added to the ranks of an already stellar Crimson Tide class, and we have to talk about it. Kamar Wheaton is a guy who possesses all the skill set you could want, right? He looks like a typical Texas running back, and what do I mean when I say that? He's got the power, he's got the speed, he's got the explosiveness. There's really not a shortage on his game coming out of high school. There are things that he can improve upon, no doubt, but there's really not a box he doesn't check, which is something that the University of Alabama is going to be very happy they got. And look, the University of Alabama already has an incredibly, incredibly loaded running back room. We're talking Jace McClellan, Robinson, we're talking, I mean, and look, I'm assuming Robertson's coming back because the ability to come back and basically not have this year count. I think Brian Robinson would be a guy that would really benefit from being more of the full-time feature back, getting himself some draft capital. But point remains, right? Bama has a very loaded running back room. Trey Sanders is hurt right now, but I have no doubt in my mind. I want nothing more than for him to come back healthy and show everybody what kind of talent he has, because I'm a big, big Trey Sanders fan. I'm a really big fan of him. Hope he comes back good. But Kamar Wheaton, even though Alabama has all that talent in the room, Kamar Wheaton's a guy that you cannot deny, right? He's a guy who I would not be surprised at all to see him getting some rotational play next year. The University of Alabama, it's very hard to start as a running back as a freshman. It's very rarely done to be a feature back as a freshman. I mean, guys like Derrick Henry were even more rotational instead of the guy, and I expect the same for Kamar Wheaton. But an interesting stat was put in front of me today, and it kind of hits on something we've talked about here on this channel, and that's that the University of Texas has a problem. Now, I got a lot of pushback when I said this, and I think some of the things I was saying were misunderstood, because I said the University of Texas is complacent, and people took that in complacency and results. But complacency strikes more than just results, right? Complacency in approach is what I was talking about. It's not that the University of Texas doesn't care if they win games. Of course they'd like to win games. My point is the University of Texas thinks just because they strap on that helmet and have that burnt orange logo, that's going to get them success. That's the complacency they have, and it shows. Look, since 2007, the year after Vince Young left to the NFL draft, the University of Texas has only put out 6 first-rounders, and none of them have been on offense. Right? Since 2009, the University of Alabama's put out 33. And then this stat right here is shown to me this morning. The top 6 players in their respective positions in the state of Texas aren't going to Texas. What positions am I talking about? Tackle, running back, wide receiver, quarterback, inside linebacker, and center. All of those guys are going to Alabama. None of them want anything to do with the University of Texas because they know they're all on offense. None of them will go in the first round. Who knows if Herman will be there, but Herman's a dumpster fire. And y'all, if you didn't listen to my podcast, we had a guy on who was recruited by Tom Herman. And he said the guy just was not trustworthy and he didn't understand why he was still at the University of Texas. So you have former guys that Herman has recruited saying that he's just not a trustworthy guy. And that, I think, is a lot of the reason we see some of the struggles at Texas. Now, look, I'm not saying Kamar Wheaton was ever considering Texas. That'd be, I mean, he might have been. I'm not sure. But, you know, great get for the University of Alabama. You know, Oklahoma's recruiting class will be just fine. They have the number one quarterback in the nation. They have a great class. They'll be just fine with Lincoln Riley up there. They have a lot of talent on that Oklahoma offense. They'll be just fine. And look, you know, this is a huge, huge get for the University of Alabama. I don't think it could be understated, having 7 5-stars in this class and basically locking it up. And y'all remember, there's an 8th 5-star that the University of Alabama is after, who over on Tide Talk Sports, Crimson Tide News and Tidbits and Rumors, they have been talking about JT Tumalea. So y'all, after you subscribe from this channel, head over there and subscribe to their channel because they have all the best news, tidbits, and everything for y'all. But that'll do it from us here today. That's it. See ya.